Hey guys, this is Feedin' Friends 91, and I'm talking about the Xbox E3 2019 conference. Now, for those who haven't watched it, spoilers ahead. You've been warned. Now, this conference, let me just say, was actually pretty good. And I gotta say that Sony's lack of conference is kind of noticeable here. What I mean by that, it seems like Microsoft may have snatched up some premieres or maybe reveals because of Sony not appearing at E3. Now, what games am I talking about? Let's just talk about Phantasy Star Online 2. That was premiered at an Xbox conference. That is strange. Now, I don't think I ever played the first one, but that's like basically Japan's most popular RPG, I think they called it, or maybe most popular online RPG. And it's just strange to see that at an Xbox conference. And I think that maybe they would premiere it at Sony's conference had Sony been at E3. So Microsoft seemed to take advantage of Sony's absence. But there were really two big things in this conference that stuck out to me. One was the announcement of Project Scarlet, and two was Xbox Game Pass. Let's talk about Game Pass first, because it was very cool how when like they showed a gameplay trailer or a reveal, in the bottom like left corner, they would be like, this coming to Game Pass at launch. And that's cool. It just makes Game Pass worth buying, in my opinion, because a lot of games are coming to it. What's also cool, they also have Xbox Game Pass Ultimate now, which where you get Game Pass for PC, you get Xbox Live Gold, and you get Game Pass for Xbox for $14.99 a month, which is a really good price for all three of those things. And right now, if you join, apparently you get the first month for $1. So those of y'all who want all three of those, now probably is one of the best times to buy. When Game Pass was first announced and whatnot, I'm pretty sure I was a little skeptical because it was like, it's just going to be those games that like didn't really sell well or whatnot. But no, they announced like Metro Exodus is coming to Game Pass today, I believe. I'm probably going to download that tonight, actually. And that's a newish game. And I'm like, wow, this whole Xbox Game Pass, it's really doing well. And they talked about Cyberpunk as well. And we got a reveal that Keanu Reeves is going to be a character. It's amazing that they're able to keep that hidden in these days of leakage. And also, he actually appeared at E3 on stage. Very nice. But other than that, next Xbox, Project Scarlet. What was it about that really kind of caught my eye? Well, the fact that they said that this is the biggest jump they've ever done. Bigger than Xbox to Xbox 360, that would mean. And that was a huge jump. So I'm amazed that they were able to make that claim. Because to me, I didn't think we were going to ever get like a bigger jump than Xbox to Xbox 360. Because that was just a massive jump in graphical quality and whatnot. To make that statement, that's a huge statement. And that means that the next Xbox is going to look amazing compared to the Xbox One, in my opinion. And they did show some what they called game engine footage of Halo Infinite, I'm assuming running on Project Scarlet. And it looked pretty good. It looked decent. Now, until we actually get gameplay footage, I'm going to be skeptical. But to make that statement, you better be able to back that up, Microsoft. Because if Project Scarlet gets revealed and I'm like, wait a minute, this isn't as big a jump, that's going to be disappointing. But they really had a good conference. They showed, I think, over 60 games, and they didn't have a lot of talking, which is good. You don't want a bunch of people talking at these conferences. You want to see games, games, games. And that's what they did. They really had people come out. They had talked for a relatively short period of time, and then they showed games. Sometimes they showed games back to back to back to back. So kudos, Microsoft. That was a really good conference this year. In my opinion, y'all clearly took advantage of Sony's absence. And y'all showed us what we wanted. Y'all showed us games, 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 announcements, and Game Pass is really looking to be worth the money. So kudos to Microsoft. Y'all did good. Anyway, what do you guys think about the Xbox E3 2019 conference? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Remember, like, share, and subscribe. And may God bless you all.